It's a game changer when there are new layout designs to work with in Notion. The new layouts allow for some exciting ways to organize your properties and pages. In this video, I wanted to do a deep dive on Notion's layouts, covering how to use it and some best practices. If you find this video useful, be sure to like, subscribe, and turn on the notification bell. Let's first go over how do you access the new layouts feature. So in order to use the new layouts, you do need a Notion database, and you can access them through the database pages. So if we go ahead and type /database, so we can just find an inline database plus new table, you can immediately access the layout settings by opening a page up, going to customize layout. And one thing to note is that this is going to apply to every page inside of that database as sort of like a default setting. So this is going to just reflect on every single page in that particular database. Now let's take a further deep dive into the layout settings by actually going into an existing template called the Ultimate Personal Finance Tracker. And this template happens to have a lot of properties, so this layout feature is going to be a game changer for this. So let's go ahead and open one up, and we can again access the customize layout option. So here we first wanted to go over the page settings. So it's kind of hidden, but if you click here, or when you first open it up, it's going to show this sidebar here with page settings. So the first option you have is between inline comments and minimal comments. So inline comments are going to make the comments show up inline, and then minimal is going to show up in this small button like this. The other thing is page discussions, whether they're expanded or off. So these are all things that you can adjust. And actually, one of the most fun features that you can access in page settings is that you can toggle off show property icons. So you can actually see these in a new light, because previously you could not turn off these icons. So this is quite exciting. So the next thing to show is that you can pin properties. So if we click the heading here, and let's say that the date is very important, so you want to pin it, then you can actually pin it here. If we click apply to all pages, you can see what it looks like. So now we see the date, start and end directly underneath the title. And keep in mind that these pin properties, there's only a maximum of 4 that you can add, so be mindful of that when you pin your properties. So the next element to cover is the property group feature. And this is something that you can't delete inside of these layouts, because this is where your properties are held. And you do have options to move these out, but basically this main box at the moment, you cannot delete or remove. You can choose what kinds of properties you want to show or hide and things like that. So that's basically just the same as you had before. And next, if we want to add sections, which is a very exciting feature of this new layout, is you can go to plus add a section. And for example, you might want to keep your formulas in one spot, and then you could have a section for key info. Then you can start adding properties to this new sections. With the key info, you would want the budget, you would want the budget graph, expenses due, expenses paid, and the income. But let's say for the formulas, you kind of want to keep them hidden and also very clear that they're formulas. So this sectionizing is just really useful. So as you can see, we have the key info up here and then the formulas down here. The next interesting element is that you can add singular properties as different sections. So if we click plus here, you can do things like add your budget as an entire section, and you can choose between large or small. And one thing that's really useful about this new layout system is that before, sometimes the text got cut off for your property names, but for really long property names, this is going to allow you to see the full thing. So let's go ahead and apply to all pages just so that we can see what this looks like. So now you can see budget like this, and then the budget here. So this is a really useful way if you want to highlight a very particular property. But not only that, there's several other features with this singular property. So if we go back to customize, and let's say that we wanted to show the budget graph, you can see it in such a big view like this that you couldn't previously. So if we apply to all pages, now we can see the budget graph really big. And now if we go back to customize layout, there's a few other things for this single property feature, which is that it looks particularly good when you add, for example, a notes property or files and media. So let's check out what that could look like. So just to showcase what this can do, I just added a files and media and a notes property. And now if we go back to our customized layout and we want to add these as single properties, we can go ahead and click files and media. We can go ahead and click plus and add the notes and then apply to all pages. So we can see a dedicated section for notes here now, as well as dedicated files and media, which are way bigger than what it used to be at the top like this. So the next piece of information regarding the layouts is that you can see here that there are relations and it's kind of grouped together. So this is something just to note if you're used to using your relations inside of this kind of minimal view. Previously, you could control click on it and then change the type of view so it would appear in your properties or appear as this minimal. But now if you want to customize this, you have to go to customize layout. And it's going to show up as a relations group. If you don't already have that relations group, you can convert it that way. So first, let's go ahead and click the three dots here. And then we're going to add to property group, for example, in the key infos. So now we have the three different kinds of relation properties up here. If you want to reconvert this into the section, you have to actually go to the expenses here. Control click it, and then you have to click add to layout and it's going to show up here. But this is still not exactly what you might be looking for. So then you have to click the three dots here and then go to advanced and then convert to relations group. And then now what you can do is to click here, click the income one, add to layout, and then you can do the same thing. Advanced add to relations group. And then here, as you can see, the expenses are shown big like this. You have to click here and then show as minimal. So then you can see it in the same view. And you can do the same for the transfer, add to layout. And then you can click the three dots here, advanced, add to relations group, and then you'll see it like this. So it's a few extra steps in order to get back to this view if this is really important to you. So this is something that was a little bit surprising at first because we usually use these kinds of minimal relation views quite often at the organized notebook. So this is kind of a surprise and maybe a sign that we might start using the relations views a little bit differently now with this new layout builder. And then the final piece of information is the add to panel. So you can actually hide information into the panel, which is really useful so that you don't clog your entire page with lots of properties. So if we just drag the property group over here, now you'll notice that this area gets a lot less cluttered. We can also move individual properties over here like this, but unfortunately the relation group doesn't seem to move in here. You can move your files and media, your notes and everything here basically to the sidebar. If you apply to all pages, you can now see this view details and it's going to show up on the side like this. So this can be very useful if you want to hide some information that's not necessarily helpful so that you can sort of declutter the page. If we go back to the customized layout, there are a few other things to keep in mind when using the new layout builder. So these are just best practices. People are probably still figuring out how to actually use the new layout in the most aesthetic and organized way. So far, what I found to be really useful is to use the sidebar to hide things that you don't want to immediately see. So that's kind of the rule number one, putting the important pinned properties up top, especially if they're things like tags, could be really useful. And the other thing is files and media typically look better when it's in its own group so that the images are bigger. And finally, if you have lots of properties, it's a really good idea to section them based on properties. So for example, a lot of these actually are not meant to be shown as a property. So it's mainly only to be shown as a gallery view. So that's why it's a good idea to hide them and also put them under formulas. So the user knows that this is not something that needs to be accessed, but at the same time, there's enough information to know that these are formulas. Thank you so much for watching. Have you been using the new layouts feature or do you still use the default layouts? Feel free to comment below if you have any questions or thoughts and hope to see you all in the next video.